Hi, in this short video, I discuss about the metabolism of cancer cells called as the Warburg effect. In a normal cell, the source of energy in presence of oxygen is oxidative phosphorylation, which releases 36 ATPs. In the absence of oxygen, the process of anaerobic glycolysis occurs, which releases only 2 ATPs. If in the presence of oxygen, glycolysis occurs, the process is called as aerobic glycolysis, and that is what happens in a cancer cell, and the process is called as Warburg effect, given by Sir Otto Warburg. This led to the hypothesis that maybe the mitochondria is defective, and if your mitochondria is defective, you get cancer. But this hypothesis was denied later, because it's the mitochondria which synthesizes macromolecules required for the replication of the tumor cells. So why is that the mitochondria synthesizing macromolecules but not ATPs? The answer to which lies in the fact that in a nutrient deficient state, the body synthesizes more ATP than macromolecules. In a nutrient excess state, the body synthesizes more macromolecules than ATP. The other important question is, what causes increase in the substrates, or in other terms, reprogramming of metabolism? The answer lies in what causes cancer: activation of oncogenes and inactivation of the tumor suppressor gene. This image from Robbins shows three important oncogenes, receptor for tyrosine kinase, PI3-AKT pathway, and the MYC, which promotes glycolysis, promotes protein and lipid synthesis, and MYC promotes increased utilization of glutamine. What is the significance of Warburg effect? Increased uptake of glucose is the mechanism by which the PET scan detects cancer using fluorodeoxyglucose as a substrate, and the other important significance is build a drug to inhibit these oncogenes or activate the tumor suppressor gene. This will inhibit the metabolism and the tumor cell dies.